He was sent to prison for 15 years for planning the murder of a Supreme Court judge. Now, Tommy Soeharto is leading a political party that will compete in next year's elections. Despite his prison term, which ended after 5 years, Soeharto's youngest son says he can still run for president.
The people will decide, and I know the people who have followed my court case saw that there is not a single witness who testified against me. Yes, the verdict was indeed heavy. I have done my term, and according to the law, now I have the same rights as anyone else.
But according to the current Indonesian law, anyone who has been sentenced to prison for more than 5 years can't run for president. His father, President Soeharto, was forced to resign following accusations of corruption and human rights abuses. Tens of thousands of students took to the streets demanding reforms. Time magazine reported that the Soeharto family had stolen billions of dollars. A government investigation was halted when Soeharto fell ill. His grave, now a monument for those who would like to see a return to his stern rule.
Soeharto, who was accused of being one of the world's most corrupt leaders, died 10 years ago without ever facing court, leaving many in Indonesia wondering how much money he and his family may have taken from the state and where it all went. Now, with his children returning to politics, it may be even more difficult to find out.
A court case was raised with claims that the Soeharto family had misused funds in a foundation set up to provide scholarships for poor children. Soeharto's own children were ordered to return $400 million, the judges said was stolen from state companies.
As you know, the United Nations and also Transparency International have said that President Soeharto has stolen more from the Indonesian state than any other president has done in the past. Between $15 billion to $35 billion is the estimate. What do you say about that?
These figures are not true. They have said my father owns billions of dollars in Europe in a Swiss bank, but until now nobody has provided any evidence. It was never proven.
If the government, for example, would establish a team to go look for all this money, for all these billions of dollars, what would you say?
Yeah, silakan.
Please go ahead. I would be glad if they did that. No problem at all. It was never proven. It was only a political rumor which was blown out of proportion.
Tommy Soeharto aims to get 80 seats in parliament at the next elections. But some Indonesians can't forget the crimes committed under his father's administration. Mugianto was kidnapped and tortured as an activist during Soeharto's rule.
I believe that the idea of reviving the teaching, the practice of Soeharto will never be accepted by the Indonesian people. At that time, the country is built on fear. People are afraid to express what they have in mind.
But 20 years on, many say Indonesia's reforms have failed to create welfare for millions of people. The widening gap between rich and poor is Tommy Soeharto's main campaign slogan, gaining some support among the country's poor, who don't mind that he served prison time for a murder. Stab Fasten, Al Jazeera, Lombok. Okay.